Okay, so Neolithic next, huh? I guess I should start with the overview, but what to include? Cornish hedges? Crying the neck, maybe? Or... wait. 5th of March? Oh god, it's St. Piran's Day! Wait! No, no, no!
The Tamar to land, the Severn is no stay, with one and all and hand in hand, and who shall be the slay?
Gaul Perrin Lowen. Happy St. Piran's Day, everyone. Since I accidentally started this series up right before St. Piran's Day, I figured I should actually make a video on it too. So we'll be starting the Neolithic next week, but today I want to take a look at the history behind the celebrations of the day, its origins, and who St. Piran, or Perrin in Kernowek, was, and what St. Piran's Day is. And also just how our culture is celebrated from around the world, and the growing levels of interest both in and out of Kernow on reconnecting with, learning about, and emphasising our culture. In essence, this video is a pure celebration of the day and of Kernowekness. So, first of all, what's St. Piran's Day? Well, it's a day on the 5th of March where we celebrate Kernow's patron saint, similar to, most famously, the Irish St. Patrick's Day. Today we celebrate this by having feasts, parades, parties, concerts, church services, some businesses even offer discounts, some pubs will hold events, and there's even a religious procession of St. Piran's relics at Piran's Abulo. Now, that's quite a varied list of things, and as you might imagine, it means very different things to different people. Historically, the day was celebrated more so than now, through a period known as Perrantide, similar to Yuletide. Perrantide takes place the week running up to the 5th of March, and would actually culminate in St. Piran's Day's religious services. Throughout this whole period, there would be feasting, dancing, merriment, and especially the consumption of alcohol, coining the 19th century phrase, as drunk as a Periner. Historically, sports such as hurling and wrestling would also take place during the celebrations, and the general atmosphere in Kernow back then would not be too dissimilar to Easter or Christmas celebrations. However, following the decline of mining and Kernowek culture in the 1860s, this holiday started to die out and fell almost extinct until the 1980s during a widespread revival of Kernowek culture and heritage during the 20th century. So that's what the day is, but now let's discuss who St. Piran actually was and why we celebrate him. He was a 5th century abbot and saint, supposedly from Ireland, and died around 480 CE, although we don't really know when he was born. He became the patron saint of tinners, and later became known as the kind of unofficial patron saint of Kernow, though there is competition for this title. So that's a similar sort of idea to St. Patrick of Ireland, St. David of Wales, St. Andrew of Scotland, and St. George of England. He was supposedly a great healer, performing miracles in Ireland as a child, which eventually led to his exile by the jealous Irish lords. This would result in, as the story goes, him washing up on a beach, later known as Piran Beach, in Kernow after having been thrown into the Irish Sea, with a millstone attached to his leg. He quickly set up a small oratory, or chapel, to preach Christianity to the locals in Kernow and West Devon, who were cut off via harsh geography from wider Roman and post-Roman England, and still held many pagan beliefs, with his first disciples reportedly being a bear, badger, and fox, some sort of Dr. Doolittle-type character. Many believed, and still do believe, that the remains of an oratory that lie on this beach today, beyond Piran's Abulo, are the remains of the original. However, it has been investigated and confirmed to be 9th century in date, though the chapel could lie on or near the original grounds, if there ever was such an oratory. The main reason he is remembered, though, and why he's the patron saint of tinners, is that he supposedly taught the Kernowek how to smelt tin. He did this by noticing his black hearthstone, a tin-bearing slab of ore, start to melt and leak tin, the white substance rising to form a white cross on the black ore, which is incidentally the origins for the present Kernowek flag, a white cross of tin on the black slab of ore. Now, Kernow has many other saints, and even two other potential patron saints, St. Michael, named in St. Michael's Mount, and St. Petrog, who Padstow is named after. A surprising number of female saints also hail from or were based in Kernow, including St. Nonna, St. David's mother. Indeed, there's an old saying that there are more saints in Kernow than in heaven, with Mortimer Collins reporting in 1886 that of the 144 parishes in England and Wales named after saints, 56 were in Kernow, despite being relatively small in both size and population. The reason why Piran rose to popularity compared to all the others is he was the standard bearer and symbol for the tin miners, or tinners, of Kernow. Kernowek tin mining was a vital part of the Kernowek economy and identity, and had been since sometime between 2000 and 1000 BCE, when the Phoenicians, and later Greeks and Romans, would trade for the metal. This history, though, does somewhat disprove the story that St. Piran discovered how to smelt tin. However, such stories of truth often get lost in embellishment over time. It's probable Piran had some link to tin and tinners, but today it's hard to say what that would have actually been. Whatever the case, as Kernow's culture became more intertwined with tinners, so too did Piran become more linked with Kernow and its identity. Now, finally, St. Piran's Day and celebrating Kernowek heritage isn't just limited to Kernow. Through the export and fame of Kernowek hard rock miners during the colonial period, and especially following the decline of mining in Kernow in the late 19th century, many Kernowek immigrants left to the shores of regions like the Americas and Oceania. So let's take a look at some of those places today, since this video and channel is also about promoting the wider Kernowek identity. Starting with the most active, and probably a surprising one to most out there, Mexico is a big proponent of celebrating its links with Kernow and the Kernowek identity, perhaps more than anywhere else in the world, and indeed the Mexican embassy in London has been pushing for greater and greater links between the two regions since the early 2000s, with Mexico even dubbing two towns in Hidalgo state as Little Cornwall. The Mexican Pachuca and Kernowek Camborne are officially twinned, and Mexican Mineral del Monte, commonly dubbed Real del Monte, and the Kernowek Red Ruth are also twinned, the ceremonies occurring in 2008. And there's even a Mexican variety of the Cornish pasty, known as the paste, which is highly popular and fuses Kernowek and Mexican cuisine. Some Mexicans claiming, tongue-in-cheek, that they are more popular and widely produced than in Kernow itself. This year, the Mexican ambassador will even be officially attending the celebrations and parade in Truro, to promote the Kernowek and Mexican links and diasporas from both regions. And in 2014, the then Duke and Duchess of Cornwall, Charles and Camilla, visited Little Cornwall and Real del Monte for the Day of the Dead celebrations in a similar capacity. Australia also has a region dubbed as Little Cornwall, apparently a title in great demand, which composes of three towns, Moonta, Cadena, and Wallaroo, sitting in the Copper Triangle in South Australia, where small celebrations are sometimes held. Official St. Piran's Day celebrations are held in New South Wales, with a flag, toasting, and nibbles event being held this year. And finally in Ballarat, Victoria, the Ballarat Cornish Group hold yearly celebrations of St. Piran's Day. Moving on to Canada, the Toronto Cornish Association celebrates the day, and in Canada, Cornish is a recognised ethnicity on their census, with 1,550 people registering as such in 2006. The New Zealand Cornish Association celebrates the day too, holding small events, And actually there are five Bards of Kernow, a role similar to the idea of getting a knighthood in the UK, from New Zealand showing the diaspora alive and well so far across the globe. Finally, the USA has, unsurprisingly, a huge Kernowek diaspora compared to the rest of the world, with an estimated 2 million people of Kernowek descent, compared to the just 500,000 living in Kernow today. The Southwestern Wisconsin Cornish Society is one of several societies in the US that celebrate their heritage, with a festival in September, and indeed a St. Patrick's Day gathering too. So if you're in any of these countries, as well as a couple of others, have a look around. There might be a small event happening somewhere near you, and it might be fun to pop along, have a chat, and try some pasties. And that's St. Patrick's Day. To me, St. Patrick's Day is a day to celebrate Kernow and being Kernowek. Whether you were born here, are living here, or have ancestors from here, or simply are just interested in our culture. As well as have some nice food and drink, of course. But I wanted to make this video to better educate people on what it actually is and the history behind St. Patrick and why he became linked to us. And perhaps show any Kernowek people watching that we're not the only ones that celebrate the day and our identity. That we do in fact have links in the globe that go much further than Wales, Brittany or Scotland. As I said in my introduction video, we're more than our stereotypes such as mining and pasties. However, I'll add to that statement here. That doesn't mean they aren't still an important part of our culture. Often the same is true for any culture stereotypes. And indeed both are closely interlinked with St. Patrick's Day and our identity as a whole. Duganis Ha Maraz. Thank you and goodbye.